Hello, everybody. Welcome to Math Defined with me, Mrs. C. And today we're going to look at improper fractions. So what is an improper fraction? Well, let's look at the definition. The definition of an improper fraction is that it is a fraction where the numerator is greater than or equal to the denominator. And you'll remember that in a fraction, the numerator is the top number and the denominator is the bottom number. So let's look at some examples. So my first example is 5/3 or 5/3. Now remember, the definition of an improper fraction is where the numerator is greater than or equal to the denominator. So I have a numerator of 5, which is greater than the denominator of 3. So 5/3 is an improper fraction. Let's take a look at another example. This one is 6/1. Now again, we're gonna look at that numerator. And if 6 is greater than or equal to 1, which it is, then 6/1 is another example of an improper fraction. The next one is 11/11. So again, we're going to take a look at that numerator. And if that numerator is greater than or equal to the denominator, then it is an improper fraction. So since 11 is equal to the denominator of 11, that means that 11/11 is an improper fraction. Now let's take a look at some non-examples. Our first non-example is 1/9. And again, we're going to look at that numerator. And I can see that that numerator is less than the denominator of 9. So this is not an improper fraction. When I look at 21/50, the numerator of 21 is not greater than the denominator of 50. So 21/50 would not be an improper fraction. My last example isn't even a fraction at all. Instead, it's a mixed number. So a mixed number is never an improper fraction. Now there's one more last thing that's very important that I want to remind you of, and that is that an improper fraction will always simplify or reduce to either a whole or a mixed number. Meaning that if I had my examples such as 5/3, say that I was adding a pair of fractions or multiplying or dividing, and I ended up with an answer of 5/3 as an improper fraction, I would need to simplify that fraction, and all improper fractions will reduce to either a whole number or a mixed number. So let's look at how to do that. So how do you simplify or reduce an improper fraction? And let's take a look at that 5/3 from our previous examples. So when you have an improper fraction, the way that you simplify that is to divide. And I know that I need to divide because I see that fraction bar between that separating the 5 and the 3. Well, that fraction bar is actually an operation sign that means to divide. So I'm going to take 5 divided by 3. And I know that 3 goes into 5 one time, and 5 minus 3 is 2, and I don't have anything left to bring down, so I know that 2 is my remainder. So that remainder of 2 becomes my numerator of my mixed number, and the 3, the denominator, does not change. So 5/3 is going to simplify to a mixed number of 1 2/3. Now let's take a look at 14/7. So again, that fraction bar is a signal that says that I need to divide. So I'm going to take 14 and divide that by 7. And I know that 7 goes into 14 two times. 2 times 7 is 14, and I have a 0 remainder. So when I have a 0 remainder, that means that my improper fraction will reduce to a whole number, which in this case is 2. And you can do mental math with that as well, because you know that 14 divided by 7 is 2. And one more, we have 11/11. And again, that fraction bar means that I'm going to be dividing. So 11 divided by 11 is 1 with 0 remainders. So 11/11 would reduce to a whole number of 1. So as you can see, 5/3, 14/7, and 11/11, when I simplified them, I ended up with either a mixed number or a whole number. Okay, let's wrap this up with a vocabulary review. And an improper fraction is a fraction where the numerator is greater than or equal to the denominator. And an improper fraction will always simplify to either a mixed number or a whole number. I hope you found this video to be helpful, and if you did, don't forget to smash that like button and let me know. And also, please consider becoming a subscriber today. Click that notification bell so that you'll know when I post new videos. And please feel free to leave any comments. I promise to read them and get back to you. And until next time, thank you so much for watching.